Year Two, welcome to your writing lesson. For today's lesson, you will need your work pack with today's date on it, which is Wednesday the 3rd of March. You need a pencil, and then you have the option. So in your booklet, you either have this sheet where you can write down your ideas, or, like we've done previously, you can get your whiteboard and write down the four senses that we'll be focusing on and a whiteboard pen. The choice is yours. So press pause now and make sure you have those things. What to do now, I want you to think about what is an expanded noun phrase. If you can't explain it, can you give me an example of an expanded noun phrase? Press pause now and complete that. So an expanded noun phrase is when you use more than one adjective to describe a noun. Have a think, what is a noun? A noun, tell me. A noun, it names a person, place, or thing. So an adjective, think about what an adjective is. An adjective describes a noun, big, little, red or brown, fantastic. So an example might be the cold white snow. This is the noun, it's a thing, we're describing it. This is an adjective and so is cold. There's two adjectives and we separate them using a comma to describe the noun. For today's lesson, you are describing a setting. You've done this before, so you've described a rainforest and you've described a beach. You're going to use exactly what you did in those lessons to help you with this lesson. This setting description will help you with the unit we'll be doing when we're back in school. We'll be focusing on the seasons and you'll be able to use a lot of the vocab or the ideas that you come up with later on in the week. First of all, you need to think about the reader. We've talked about engaging the reader, making sure they want to carry on reading. And in order for them to want to keep on reading, you need to be able to help them paint a picture in their mind. So imagine that they can't see the picture that you have. You need to describe it so well that they can imagine it. To help us do that, I found a video and we'll watch this to help us think about the different sentences, the different senses. So what you can touch, see, smell, hear. We're not focusing as much on taste, but if you come up with any ideas, write them down. So you can have your whiteboard with you or your workbook and write down some ideas of the sentences whilst we're watching this. So you should have written down some ideas of things you could hear, see, touch, taste, smell, maybe not as much taste, which is fine. If you feel like you've got some more ideas that you'd like to write down, press pause now, or you can go back and re-watch this video as many times as you'd like to write down all of your ideas. So we've watched the video now, we've collated some of our ideas, so we've got them together. So on the screen you'll see I've written down what I can see, touch, smell and hear. I've only written down a few ideas and I know that you'll have many more than this. I'm also now looking at the picture to find some ideas from this picture by itself. So over here I can see a lamppost and it's all by itself. So I would describe it as a lamppost. Then over here you can see lots of trees and the trees. If you look at this lamppost, it's quite tall, but the trees are much, much taller, so I'm going to describe them as towering please. Then finally, you can see there's snow falling. So I'm going to describe the snowflakes, the delicate snowflakes. So you're going to do exactly what I've done in a minute. So this is just an opportunity for you to press pause. Make sure you've got all the ideas that you want written down. You can either do this on your whiteboard or on the worksheet in your booklet. So have some time, press pause, and then come back when you've got your ideas. So now that we have our ideas, we're ready to write our description. So in the green box, I have some sentence starters. I've used one of the sentence starters I've used in the forest. And the reason we use sentence starters are so that our sentences do not become repetitive, so we change them up. And it allows you to describe a lot more of the forest. I've also got all the ideas in this box for what I can see, the ideas that I wrote down, and now I'm going to put them together. So in the picture, I know I can see a lamppost, and the lamppost has a golden flickering light. The word flickering just means that sometimes the light is bright and sometimes it's weak. And now I'm going to think about what that flickering light is doing. So I can see a lamppost with a golden flickering light. I'm going to think about what it's doing to the snow. And I'm going to say that it lights up the snow. Another word for light up is illuminated. My turn, illuminated. Your turn. It's just another word for light up. So I'm going to write my sentence. In the forest, there was a, what was there? There was a lamppost, thank you. So there was a lamppost. And what did it have? It had a golden. Golden is an adjective, well done. I need a comma because I'm using an expanded noun phrase because I'm saying that the light was also flickering, which is another adjective to describe the light. So golden flickering light that, oh, can you remember what that word was that I just said for lit up? Have a think, say it to me. Fantastic, it's illuminated. Illuminated the fluffy. I'm going to end with a full stop. So I'm just going to read my sentence, make sure it has a capital letter, has a full stop, and is a complete idea. In the forest, there was a lamppost with a golden flickering light that illuminated the fluffy snow. Now, if you're reading that in your head, you would paint a picture of a lamppost that had a light that was sometimes weak and sometimes bright, and it's illuminating, so the light is going onto the fluffy snow around it. That's what you want your reader to be able to imagine. You want them to imagine the picture. So now it's your turn. You have some sentence starters on the screen in this green box. You'll have your ideas written down either on the whiteboard or in your booklet of the things that you can see, hear, smell, touch. Some of you may have written taste as well. And then you have the picture that you're describing. You're going to put all of your ideas together and describe the picture so that the reader can create an image in their mind. If you need some extra help of imagining or thinking of the senses, remember there's a video at the start that you can rewind and watch again. Have fun, and I can't wait to see your work that you put on Seesaw, and see you all tomorrow. Bye!